Hi, it's me, Carrie KH, and do you have a Twitch channel with VODs that need to be edited down?
Yeah, I have a Twitch channel with VODs that need to be edited down.
That's awesome.
I always try to upload highlight reels of my content to YouTube so more people can watch them, but man, editing takes forever.
I understand the struggle, but wait, how do you edit videos if you don't even have hands to move the mouse with?
I use eye tracking software to move the mouse around, and speech recognition to click the mouse when I say click.
Whoa, that's smart. Anyway, if you can relate to the struggle of editing Twitch VODs for hours, then get hyped, because I have good news for you. This software of ours, called Jump Cutter, has a new feature called the VODinator that'll do all the editing for you. It uses the engagement levels of the chat history and other indicators to detect which periods of the VOD are the most, interesting, and it throws out the rest, all automatically. No manual work is required.
Whoa, no manual work is required? That sounds so nice!
Yeah, I know, right? Correction, of course, if you want a video to perfectly match the vision in your head, you're gonna have to do a bit of manual editing. But this tool can get you most of the way there, with much less effort than doing it by hand. I've tried it out, and it's honestly a lifesaver. Okay, let me show you how it works in action. Hey guys, so here's a demonstration of how to use the VODinator in action. So first, you're gonna start Jump Cutter the Pro program by just double clicking it. You select VODinator. Now hopefully by this point you have both the ID of the VOD and the video file itself on your computer.
It's Carrie tech support time.
Okay, but if you don't yet know how to get a Twitch VOD file onto your computer, let me show you how. First, go to Settings, Channel and Videos, and then Stream. And before you start streaming, make sure you have the Store Past Broadcast setting on. If it's on, then after you finish streaming, you should see a VOD of your most recent stream under Recent Broadcasts. Click on it, and first off, notice that the URL has the VOD ID number right here. To download the file, just click on the three dots, click on Edit, and you should see this window show up with six actions in purple. Just click Download.
Done with Carrie tech support time. Also, third-party tools like Twitch Leecher allow you to download other people's VODs, but we don't condone that, because who wants to be a leech?
Drag a video file into the top where it says please choose a video file. So right now I'm using Miniland 333's VODs from earlier today. You can also select the number of highlights and the length of sections, but if you just go with the default, you'll get a good sampling of what we're trying to do here. Then click Start Project, and it'll just start churning away. So right now, a lot of the data is being sent over to the Jump Cutter servers, and those servers are the ones who will be doing the calculations to figure out which sections of the video are the most engaging or just worth saving in the final edit. So now it's already done. It actually didn't take 5 minutes, it took more like 20 seconds. You just click Add Highlights, and now you can see that this timeline is the entire, roughly 2 hours VOD that's unedited from Miniland. But these green bits at the bottom show the parts that the algorithm thinks are the most interesting. If you want, you can tweak it manually by clicking on these handlebars and dragging them. So if you want more of this section here to show up, you just drag it longer. If you want less of it, drag it shorter. Of course, you can play through it to see what these clips are.
Never mind. Okay, second run's gonna make it to 8.
Okay, so maybe that was high engagement because Miniland decided to forfeit that run and try a new one. So I don't know what the chat was saying at the time. Maybe they were saying, like, rest in peace or F, who knows. Anyway, when you're satisfied with all the segment boundaries, just click the scissors icon to actually do the snipping out. And that's gonna snip out everything that wasn't part of those highlighted sections. Just leaving you with that cream of the crop stuff. So that this Twitch VOD doesn't take 2 hours to watch, it only takes 5 minutes or so. So if we zoom in and start at the beginning and then click play, we only have the interesting stuff. So there's a death there.
It wasn't allowed to happen. I was playing too
well. Oh, you can actually see the chat in the corners. So you can see this thing, no, rest in peace, 454 first attempt.
I didn't get the good beats alive.
Since the highlight sections are 30 seconds, let's just jump forward to the end of this 30 second chunk. Then there's another cut. And then something else happens here, probably, because the chat is the most active. Oh, it's because of that.
Okay, I think I did 5 frames of love.
Now, I'm no expert, but I believe this was a failed attempt to do a flagpole glitch.
But either way, when you're done with all of that, you can click Render. And you can either choose to render directly to an MP4 file, which is your traditional video file, no strings attached, or you can export to an XML file, which is basically just the descriptions of the beginnings and ends of these boundaries. And what's cool about that is you can actually import those XML files into other video editing softwares like Premiere or Final Cut. And from there you can add fancier editing or you can mix it with your pre-existing workflow, which is convenient for a lot of different reasons. So I'm gonna just show you how to do the XML right now. Click Export.
It's Carrie tech support time.
Okay guys, if you go with the XML approach, then you'll have an XML file sitting on your computer here. And if your normal editor is something like Premiere, then just click Open Project and choose the XML file as if it's a Premiere project. When it's done loading, you'll see each of the 10 clips just listed here in the Premiere project. And you can do whatever you want with them, such as applying crazy effects like this, or this, or this, or this, whatever that does. Anyway, when you're satisfied with all of that, then you can just export it like any other Premiere project, and you'll be good to go. And when Premiere's done with that, poof, it's our finished video file. It's 5 minutes long, fully watchable, and fully uploadable to YouTube.
Done with Carrie tech support time.
So yeah, that's how our new Vodinator works. Check it out at the link in the description. We're planning on adding support for YouTube live streams too, which I guess we'd call the Tubinator, but we're not quite there yet. Zooming out a little, this whole tool is still called Jump Cutter, just like that video from 2 years ago, and the goal of this larger project is to create a video editor that will help beginners and experts automate video editing. Based on feedback we've gotten so far, it seems to be the most useful for students, YouTubers, streamers, teachers, and podcasters. That students category makes the most sense to me because that's why I originally coded the prototype in the first place, to trim down my boring college lecture videos. But for the other categories, well, I also sympathize with you guys, because across my 13 years of making YouTube videos, 10 years of editing them, and 5 years of being a college student, I've bumped into dozens of IRL friends who've told me they've wanted to start a YouTube channel, or even did start by creating one or two well-edited videos. But the tedious task of continuously and consistently editing videos to grow a channel just didn't fit into their busy schedules. In short, we just noticed that manual video editing takes way too much time, and usually isn't that fun for most people anyways. And while it is true that automated editors will always fall a little short of human editors when it comes to understanding of humor, storytelling, and attention span, they will honestly get you 90% the way there with 1% of the effort. If that gets even one new YouTuber over that daunting hurdle to start YouTubing in the first place, I think that's worth it. And as a reminder, this project is in beta, so bugs will still occasionally come up. But we've got a community Discord server where users can discuss bugs, which we're listening to. So hopefully, over the next few months, those bugs can get ironed over, and new features that you guys recommend can be added too, such as auto sound effects or auto zooming or whatever. At this point, I should give you a description about who we are. Hi, I'm Carrie, and I coded a prototype of this project 2 years ago, and uploaded a demonstration video of me using it to this CarrieKH channel in 2019. That's what started this whole shebang. I'm part of Jump Cutter's team now, but I'm definitely not the only one working on it behind the scenes, not by a long stretch. First off, big thanks to Peter for managing this project and finding everyone and assembling this team. But secondly, huge thanks to the many talented developers who have been grinding away, coding it up for the past few months. I'm saying we should give our biggest appreciation to Andre, Devin, Efe, Caden, Max, Jacob, Bottersnipe, Garrett, Lucas, Kira,
GCK Accounting,
and Diogo, who have all gotten involved with developing Jump Cutter software at some point or another. You guys are the real OGs, and many of you have brought skills to the table that I just completely don't have, like working with AWS or creating new video renderer encoding things. Okay, enough with that. That brings me to my next point, which is that we really want you to get a feel for how Jump Cutter can improve your workflow. So we're giving everybody a 2-week free trial to experiment with it however they want. If you sign up in the next couple days, you'll get a permanent discount too, which is sort of like the way Notch did it with Minecraft Alpha in 2010. Yes, that does mean that Jump Cutter will eventually cost money, but I want to be fully honest with you here. All the developers I listed earlier, when I've watched them put in months of valuable work into this Jump Cutter project, like, they've got a lot of drive to just make the code as good as possible, and I think they should be compensated generously for that, which will only be possible with a big user base. Oh, and plus, we'd like to add as many new features as possible too, like the auto sound effect adder, but that also means more developers. So if you buy Jump Cutter, you're sorta investing in the future growth of this software, which I think is pretty cool. So, to software developers in the audience who want to join our team, let us know via the links in the description. We are also looking for help from AI engineers, venture capitalists, UI/UX designers, and people who are savvy with SEO, marketing, and more. It would be really cool to have you on board, and we might hold competitions for designers and developers open to the community. We might even do another internship program like the one we did last summer, depending on how much people want it. Anyway, yeah, just give us a holler in the developer's Discord server or something. But now that spiel's over, I do want to say, I know most of you in the audience are just watching for the lulz. It's just reality that there will always be more casual consumers of video than producers of video, and more producers of video than developers of video editing software. I'm actually not quite sure about that last one, but that's honestly fine and dandy. But to you consumers out there, hello! I know a good chunk of you have wondered what it's like to start a YouTube channel. You may have even fantasized about what it feels like to put yourself out there more, like AK Soccer Legend with his amazing soccer content, go subscribe, in the hopes of growing a community of viewers interested in your content. Well, you can try now. The whole mission statement of this jump cutter thing is, I guess, to lower the barrier of entry between those viewers with a dream and the elite YouTube club that they might be dreaming about. We're all humans here, all Homo sapiens. Whenever you're ready to head on over, welcome to the club. Okay, time to end the video now. Again, thanks to Peter, Andre, Devin, FA, Caden, Max, Jacob, Bottersnipe, Garrett, Lucas, Kira,
GCK Accounting,
Diogo, and many, many others. I'll see you in my next video. Bye, everyone!
Oh, PS, two last things before I go.
One, people have been asking me for a more complete programming tutorial in processing, so good news. Check out my 10-part series that I uploaded to Abacaba last December. Two, if you're curious about why I was gone from YouTube for 6 months, well, I have 5 other channels that weren't all gone, but also you can watch this video for a clearer explanation. Okay, thanks for listening through that, and goodbye.